Now, a NASA spacecraft is about to arrive at the largest planet in the solar system, Jupiter. The probe was launched in 2011 and has travelled nearly 2 billion miles. Entering into Jupiter's orbit will be the mission's most critical phase. But if the spacecraft succeeds, it will give us our best understanding of the planet to date. Our science correspondent, Rebecca Morell, has more.
The giant of our solar system. Beneath its clouds, Jupiter is a world shrouded in mystery. But we're about to see it up close.
3, 2, 1, ignition and liftoff.
NASA's Juno spacecraft blasted off in 2011. It's been on an epic journey, traveling nearly 3 billion kilometers. Now, finally, Jupiter's in its sights, but it faces its biggest challenge. To be grabbed into orbit, Juno needs to slam on its brakes. If the timing is off, the $1 billion mission could be lost.
The team's feeling a mixture of excitement and anticipation with tension, because we have a really difficult maneuver ahead of us to get into orbit, and if it doesn't go just right, we'll fly right past the planet.
But if Juno succeeds, the science will begin.
This spacecraft's going to get closer to Jupiter than we've ever been before. It will skirt over the giant red spot, a colossal storm raging on the planet. It will search for water and oxygen and peer beneath the clouds to reveal what lies at the planet's core.
It could even shed light on the origins of the solar system. Jupiter's thought to have been the first planet to form and has remained largely unchanged. But studying this colossal world won't be easy. This spacecraft's built like an armoured tank. It will have to survive everything that Jupiter throws at it.
When Juno goes into orbit around Jupiter, we're going to be going through this really nasty, hazardous region, the radiation belts that are very close to the planet. And they are nasty and could destroy and attack all of the electronics. So we have to be careful.
Juno's closing in fast on Jupiter. Scientists now face a tense wait to see if their mission will succeed. Rebecca Morell, BBC News, NASA Mission Control, Pasadena.
Well, with me now is Dr. Francisco Diego from University College London's Department of Physics and Astronomy. And in Leicester, I'm joined by Dr. Leigh Fletcher from the University of Leicester, who will be looking at the data this mission provides. Gentlemen, thanks very much indeed for joining us. If I could start with you, Francisco, here in the studio. This is a scary moment, actually, isn't it, after 5 years?
Well, it is a bit frightening. It's not only the radiation belts of Jupiter, it's also Jupiter rings. That Jupiter also has rings, the same as Saturn, but although much fainter. But it still have a lot of dust and particles there, and the spacecraft is going to go through those, and then there is a risk of being damaged. Although we must remember the Cassini spacecraft went more or less through the rings of Saturn, and it was not damaged. So the risks are very, very small, but still there. Yeah, it's a bit scary, as you say.
Okay. All our fingers are crossed. Dr. Fletcher, getting into Jupiter's orbit is such a difficult maneuver. What exactly is going to be happening to Juno as it tries to do this?
Okay, so Juno is coming into the Jupiter system from above, so it's coming in high over the North Pole. And what's going to happen is it's going to fire its main engine for a period of about 35 minutes, which will slow it down from the tremendous velocities it currently has, over 165,000 miles per hour, down to a tiny 130,000 miles per hour that'll allow it to go into orbit around Jupiter. Now, over that time, it's going to be entering this rather unknown environment, closer to the giant planet than we have ever been in the past. And we simply don't know what the conditions might be like there. But Juno really is by itself right now. All of these programs have been uploaded to the spacecraft, and it's going to be executing them over the next 12 hours or so in an autonomous fashion. We can't influence it now from Earth, so we have to cross our fingers and our toes that everything's been calculated properly and that the NASA engineers and scientists have done their job. But I think people are nervous but cautiously optimistic that Juno will be in orbit by the time we all wake up tomorrow morning.
Sure. Okay. Dr. Diego, what are we hoping to learn from this mission? What are we hoping to get from Jupiter?
Jupiter is it's a very important planet in the solar system. It's probably the planet that formed first, because at the time when the Sun was still forming, the Sun hadn't had the energy to blow away all this material out of which Jupiter is made of, which is mainly hydrogen. So it's telling us about the formation, the early stages of the formation of the solar system. We know very little about the interior of Jupiter. Juno will have microwave instruments that are able to penetrate the atmosphere of Jupiter for several hundred kilometers deep. And also, we will be in a position to determine how much water is there, and if Jupiter has or not a solid core in the very, very center. We know that Jupiter is mainly made out of hydrogen and helium, as the stars are. It's very high pressure, it's very high temperature, several thousand degrees inside, and the temperature goes to millions of atmospheres. So those conditions need to be well studied about the interior of Jupiter. Very important to know that.
Sure. Dr. Fletcher, what will studying Jupiter tell us about Earth, possibly? Anything?
Well, you can think of Jupiter like a giant time capsule. So it basically contains all of the material that was incorporated into that giant planet when it first formed. And the reason we want to know why Jupiter, or how Jupiter formed in the first place, is because its influence on the rest of the solar system was so far and wide ranging. We believe it migrated both inwards and outwards through the solar nebula when it was first born and when our own planet was young. And therefore it could have influenced the formation of our world and also the delivery of some of those key ingredients like water and volatiles and the material that make life possible here on Earth could have been delivered simply because Jupiter was perturbing all of this solar system debris in the early days of the solar system. Now, if we can answer that question for Jupiter, which is our closest and best known example of a giant planet, then maybe, just maybe, we might be able to answer similar questions for giant planets around other stars and how important those planets have been for the formation, potentially, of habitable environments around other solar systems. So who knows? We're not shying away from the big questions here, and Juno really could get to grips with how Jupiter formed back 4 billion years ago. So a very exciting mission.
Yes, very exciting indeed. Gentlemen, thanks for joining us. Dr. Leigh Fletcher and Dr. Francisco Diego. Thank you.